God, you who in your inscrutable providence will that the church be united to the sufferings of your Son, grant, we pray, to your faithful who suffer for your name's sake a spirit of patience and of charity, that they may be found true and faithful witnesses to the promises that you have made through our Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Jesus said to his apostles, "Behold, I am sending you like sheep in the midst of wolves. So be shrewd as serpents, but simple as doves. But beware of men, for they will hand you over to the courts. They will scourge you in their synagogues, and you will be led before governors and kings for my sake, as a witness before them and the pagans. When they hand you over, do not worry about how you are to speak or what you are to say. You will be given at that moment what you are to say, for it will not be you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father speaking through you. Brother will hand over your brother to death, and the father his child. Children will rise up against parents and have them put to death. You will be hated by all because of my name. But whoever endures unto the end will be saved. And when they persecute you in one town, flee to another. Amen. I say to you, you will not finish the towns of Israel before the Son of Man comes." The Gospel of the Lord. So the Lord very clearly prophesied of the persecution that those who witnessed and proclaimed his name in the gospel would suffer down through the ages. Today relates particularly to those in China. We know that even continues unto today with certain religious sects, like the Uyghur Muslims. And from the ages gone by, the martyrs who have willingly offered themselves, who almost joyfully entered into death in order that they become as witnesses to the Lord, are bringing to a close today our reading from Genesis, the saga of Joseph. And I don't want us to forget how powerfully the providential hand of God was involved in that. So Joseph, of course, one of the 12 sons of Jacob, was left for dead initially, then sold into slavery to the Ishmaelites, and sold them into slavery in Egypt. Raised up by God, given these inordinate gifts of reading and understanding dreams to the very viceroy, the second in command of Pharaoh, and accomplishes so much the father's plan that ultimately Jacob and all of his sons and their families, 70 in total, would journey to Egypt, would be well received because of Joseph, set up in Goshen, and they would grow exponentially to the point Your spirit, like the new fall, so the